Challenge accepted. Hi, I'm Claire and I like some books. In 2021, I have read 119 books and short stories in a wide variety of genres whose intended audiences were mostly adult or middle grade. I have young kids, so what I'm gonna do is go through my list. I've logged them all into Goodreads and I'll try to give the briefest summary I can. And as I see, we are starting off strong. The first book, which is not at all representative of the rest of them on this list, is The Righteous Mind: Why Good People Are Divided by Politics and Religion, written by Jonathan Haidt. It's a nonfiction book about morality and how people around the world perceive it. I rated it 5 stars and I do think it's a must read for basically anybody on this planet. Even though there are a few chapters that are but I have to speed this up if I want to be done today. NPCs, written by Drew Hayes. I rated it 5 stars. It's a nice fantasy novel about NPCs, non-player characters, and what they do when the players are not around. Murder by Other Means, written by John Scalzi. Science fiction, worth 5 stars. In the fairly near future, people can't die, so you have to kill them by other means. Man, the year had started really well for me. And then I read Gardens of the Moon by Steven Erikson. This is the first of the Malazan books. People love that series, but even the hardcore fans will tell you that until like book 3, you are not gonna get anything. And well, from reading the first one, I 100% agree on the not understanding part. Don't know how the series as a whole is because I ain't reading it. Got better stuff to do. The Bookwoman of Troublesome Creek by Kim Michelle Richardson. It's a very well-researched history novel, reads very easily, but I had a few issues with it, so I gave it only 4 stars, but it does still mean it's very good. Inside Jobs, Tales from a Time of Quarantine by Ben H. Winters. 3-star read. It's like readable or, well, listenable. This is an Audible original. It's supposed to be a funny look at how organized crime would work while quarantine is in place. The humor and the twists didn't really work for me, but it wasn't the worst thing I read either, so. Another Audible original, Andrea Vernon and the Corporation for Ultrahuman Protection. The whole book is written from a perspective of a secretary working for an agency that employs superhumans. Love the premise, absolutely adore some of the characters, but the pro-capitalism messages in this book are... But if you can ignore that, I do recommend this lesson. Ember by Travis Bagwell, the first book in the Awaken Online series. I love this book while I was reading it before I got to the end. An elderly disabled character is our main focus point and he finds another life in what is basically an MMORPG. Love the premise, love the themes that are in there, and then the ending just spoils it. Washes everything that was good down the drain. Needless to say, I will not be picking up the sequels. The Original by Brandon Sanderson and Mary Robinette Cowell. Science fiction as what it should be. Not completely mind-blowing, but very well executed. Do recommend. A Series of Unfortunate Events. The first book, The Bad Beginning, I heard a multi-voice recording. The book is by Lemony Snicket, and I really, really like the book. If you don't know what it's about, I highly recommend watching the Netflix series, The Series of Unfortunate Events, and then you'll know. I think the series captures the books amazingly. The Reptile Room is the second book in the series, that too. Highly recommend. Red Mars by Kim Stanley Robinson. My attempt on reading a sci-fi classic. This is supposed to be a hard SF, and while it does go very deep into some science, the psychology in this one is really bad. As much as the physics is good, the psychology is horrendous. I would recommend this only to hardcore, hard science fiction fans. An Absolutely Remarkable Thing by Hank Green. and its sequel, A Beautifully Foolish Endeavor, also by Hank Green. I think these two books should be read together because they kind of form a whole. And I do give both of them 5 stars. It's a science fiction-y, urban type of thing, with the main focal point being social media and how it affects stuff. Love it. The Hunger Games by Suzanne Collins. The first one, The Hunger Games, 5 stars. A dystopian future. One girl has to take care of her family. Then The Hunger Games begin. I mean, if you don't know what The Hunger Games are, what are you doing here? Anyway, The Hunger Games, 5 stars. Catching Fire, the sequel, 5 stars. Mockingjay, the ending, 4 stars. I don't think the writing was on the level of the previous two, but still a very good end to a very good series. Front Page Fatality by Lindy Walker. I gave it 5 stars, even though I'm not certain anymore what this was about. A detective? No, this was the journalist. Nice read. Do recommend, if you like mystery type of things. Cry Dance by Kirk Mitchell. I don't remember this book at all. I gave it 3 stars. Elevation by Stephen King. I read that before 2021. Why is it here? It's a nice quick read. Not very Stephen Kingy, which is why I read it. Land of Shadows by Rachel Hafzal Hall. I gave it 4 stars. I have no idea what it's about. Skies of Ash by Rachel Hafzal Hall. Possibly the sequel. Is that about the detective? This one got 4 stars from me as well. Moving on. How It Ends by Rachel Hafzal Hall. Again, an Audible original. Well, apparently I liked Rachel's voice because I did read 3 of her books. So that must mean something, but I also have no idea what any of those are about. Maybe we can say they are fine, but forgettable. Split the Party by Drew Hayes. This is the sequel to the NPCs. If you like that kind of light fantasy nonsense, this book is great. It doesn't take itself seriously at all. Lock In by John Scalzi. Loved it. It's science fiction in a world post a pandemic that left people locked inside their minds. And now they can have robot bodies in which they can go around and do stuff. If you like science fiction, you will love this. Then we have Head On, also by John Scalzi, which is the sequel to The Lock In. Science fiction, 5 stars for me. Murder Bot. The first book is All Systems Red by Martha Wells. I gave it 5 stars. Again, science fiction. Written from the perspective of a robot. I still can't pronounce that word. Sorry. Then we have the sequel, Artificial Condition, again by Martha Wells. Again, 5 stars. Good fun read. An Audible original, Brackish Waters by Matt Boren, about a very opinionated white lady who slowly comes to the realization that she is being an ass to everybody. I found it fun. The Martian by Andy Weir. Wow, I read a lot of sci-fi in the first half of the year. Anyway, The Martian, this to me is what sci-fi is about big ideas and humanity coming together to fix a problem. Love it. And I might as well review Project Hail Mary, also by Andy Weir, at this point, because Project Hail Mary feels like a spiritual sequel to The Martian. If you loved The Martian, you will absolutely adore Project Hail Mary. And they are both about a science guy who is somewhere alone and has to deal with all kinds of problems. And when I say all sorts of problems, I mean the ones you can solve using natural sciences. I'm sorry, I just got so excited because I saw what's the next one. Unsold by Will White. It's the first book of the Cradle series, which is one of my favorite series of all time. It's a second world fantasy. I'm gonna say it right now. The writing style is not the greatest, but this is extra funny if you've read the book because the books have a lot of buts in them. But I like the story so much. It's so, as the series goes on, the books get better. With an exception. So the first book, amazing. Love it. The second one is Soulsmith. Love it too. Third one, Black Fame. Great. The fourth one, Skysworn. Also amazing. And by the way, do read these books in order. Like if you try to jump in, you're not gonna get. You need to read these books in order to optimize your fun. Then we have Ghostwater, and this is the one I like a bit less than the others, but that is all rectified with Underlord. There are quite a few books in this series. Uncrowned, amaze. Wintersteel, love it. Bloodline, yes, we are still talking about the Cradle series, yes. And after Bloodline, I think comes Reaper, which is definitely the best one. Again, it's only the best one if you have read all of the previous ones. If you just jump into here, you will have no idea what's going on. But the series as a whole, but again, I said but again. Oh, Will, you have such a similar way of writing as I have of talking. Gonna skip this one. Born Lippy, How to Do Female by Jo Brandt. A non-fiction book by a UK comedian. I found it funny, but not as funny as I think Jo would have liked me to find it funny. 3 stars. Northern Spy by Flynn Berry. I liked this book while I was reading it. It's about the troubles in Northern Ireland. And while I did find the book very compelling, I had to take 1 star away because it was not as well researched as I would have liked it to be for such a serious topic. Then we have some middle grade. Yay! Secret of the Water Dragon by Tracy West. It's the first book in the Dragon Masters series. Or is it the second one? It's one of them. I also read Saving the Sun Dragon and Der Aufstieg des Drachen. I did read them in German with my kids. The whole book series is called Dragon Masters. It's like 20 books long or something like that. My kids like the books, but my son is so obsessed with dragons. If you would put a dragon into some huge pile of shit, he would still love that shit because it contains a dragon. So he loves the books. I think that by this point in time, even our middle grade novels should have a bit more than just tropes. Eleanor Oliphant is Completely Fine by Gail Honeyman. I devoured this book. It was amazing. I loved it. And then I put it down and started to think about it. And then I realized I hate it. It's a contemporary novel that's supposed to be about loneliness, but it has so many issues. Curing alcoholism in a day just by stopping drinking. Gee, if only somebody had thought of that before. Oh, man, this book is gonna save so many lives. House of Glass by Susan Fletcher. I think it's set in the beginning of 20th century or somewhere like that. About a now woman who has an issue with her bones. And then has to deal with that and, you know, everything else that comes in life. I really like this book and I would recommend it. We Are All Completely Beside Ourselves by Karen Joy Fowler. A contemporary novel, has a few issues, and I'm trying to be spoiler free here. So I'm just going to say it's very well researched and fun to read. So even though it's not a 5-star read, I do recommend it. Das kleine böse Buch. It's in German, but I'm gonna do it because it's a trilogy and it's over there on my shelf. You just can't see it. Literally just off the screen a bit. It's The Little Bad Book. 1, 2, and 3. The book is talking directly to you and you have to solve some puzzles. It's middle grade. It's fun. I like it. And the kids loved it too. Oh, we have a few more from the Dragon Masters. I did read a few more. Power of the Fire Dragon and Song of Poison Dragon. Do I have to say more? The New Confessions of an Economic Hitman, a non-fiction book by John Perkins, who was apparently an economic hitman. So he explains what he was doing while he was an economic hitman and why. The book is hard to read because of the writing style at some points, but also because of the subject matter, because it's, let's say, it doesn't paint America in a good light. But it is a book worth reading, and I do recommend it. Another John Scalzi, Richards from John Scalzi. Science fiction, Enterprise, the Richards. Fun, but nothing spectacular. And then I gave John Scalzi another go with The Collapsing Empire. I rated it 3 stars. Not really that good. The Couple Next Door by Shari LaPena. It's not a murder mystery, but it is a mystery, like a kidnapping mystery. Is that a genre? It's a very fast read, very interesting. You just mustn't think about it after you finish the book, because then some things will not make any sense. As long as you are able to keep that away, it's a fun read. I really can't, so I gave it 3 stars. Llama Drama, a two-woman, 5,500-mile cycling adventure through South America by Anna McNuff. I gave it 4 stars. It's a fun read. It's a traveling journal where Anna went with her friend on a cycling adventure through South America. Journal 29 by Dimitris Chatsapakis. This is not a book in the traditional sense. It's a puzzle book. Each page has a puzzle, and you go to an online site where you put in the answer, and if the answer is correct, the book will tell you the password that you will need to solve further mysteries. I've read this one with my husband. We had quite a lot of fun with it, but there were also some very, very frustrating moments where you wouldn't get the spelling right, and then of course the website would say, oh, it's wrong. If you like these sort of things, do check it out, but beware that it is frustrating at times. The Strange Case of the Alchemist's Daughter by Theodora Goss. Gave it 4 stars. This book is like historical fiction. It relies heavily on you knowing all of the classical monsters, and then you have a group of women who come together with those special powers. I'm not convincing myself to read the book again. But it was fine. Again, I have to make an exception. Junge Frau am Fenster stehend, Abendlicht, Blaues Kleid by Alena Schröder. It's a book in German, but it's one I really, really loved. A contemporary, but with flashbacks to a previous time of her great-grandmother and what choices she made and what choices the protagonist is now making. And I really like this book. If it ever comes out in English, or if you can read German, I highly recommend this book. Artemis by Andy Weir. It was like a couple of minutes ago when I said how The Martian and Project Hail Mary are one of the best science fiction novels out there, like of all time, and they are both by Andy Weir. Well, Artemis is also by Andy Weir, but this time we don't have a male protagonist, but a female one. And let me tell you, Andy Weir can write a really good, bitchy male scientist. Like, mwah. Females, no. This book is horrible. I do not recommend it to anybody. Another horrible science fiction with a female protagonist written by a male writer. Can you see a pattern emerging? You're Going to Mars by Rob Dierks. I think this is supposed to be YA. It's really bad. Missing Molly by Natalie Borelli. A contemporary thriller? I think it's a thriller. Or is it a mystery? Mystery thriller? Has one of the best openings ever in the sense of you are in there, like after the first page, you know what this book is gonna be about and you are here for it. And then the rest of the book does not let you down. I gave John Scalzi another go. Utere nihil non extra quiritationem sus. I don't like the title. A science fiction, very tropey one, nothing new, but it's also very short, so I cannot hate it that much. Scalzi again. Man, I've read like what? All of Scalzi's work this year? The B Team. This had so much potential, and then I think it just fell flat for me. So, meh. Parachutes by Kelly Yang. One, of the best books, period. Contemporary, about Asian kids going to high school in America. Female perspectives. Amazingly written, amazing story, amazing everything. It does come with a few trigger warnings, so keep that in mind, but amazing book, amazing. Watch Me Disappear by Janelle Brown. I like the book. I even gave it 5 stars. I don't think it deserved 5 stars. I'll have to change that to 4. It's a nice mystery. It just had a few, I'm gonna say slow points that I didn't like that much, but overall a fun read. Shutter Island by Dennis Lehane. I wanted to read this one because I enjoyed the movie so much. Didn't really care for the writing style of the book. And I feel like if you know what's coming, it just makes the whole book boring. Some books are even better when you know the twist ending. This one isn't. And I gave Andy Weir another shot with James Moriarty Consulting Criminal, a collection of short stories where we follow Moriarty from Sherlock Holmes. These short stories were fine. They were very predictable and none of them were mind-blowing, so skippable. Level 5 by William Ledbetter. Science fiction, AIs, near future, starts interestingly enough, goes on interestingly enough, and then the book is over. But the story isn't. Felt very let down by that. Unfortunately, not enough to not read level 6, which is the sequel. Has the same problem the previous one had. Like, it's fine, you're getting into the story, and then it ends. I mean the book, but not the story. Air Today, Pawn Tomorrow. Eric Uglund. About a guy's consciousness being transported into a game, let's say, maybe? We're not sure on the details, but it doesn't matter anyway because this book does not take itself seriously. It's very similar in tone to the NPCs and it's just a fun read. Andy Weir again with another short story collection, The Egg and Other Stories. And when they say The Egg and Other Stories, they say The Egg and Other Stories. You know, we had to fill up a book. The Egg is this mind-blowing story, which even Kurz Gesagt has turned into a video. That's how amazing it is. And then there are some other stories that you can read or not. Beast Quest! Yeah, another middle grade about dragons! What do you think? Who picked that one up? This one I hated even more than the Dragon Master series I mentioned before, because this one is literally just trope after trope after trope after trope, and it is done so poorly. The book is so horrible. So horrible. Super Forecasting, The Art and Science of Prediction by Philip E. Titok and Dan Gardner. Love this book so much. Nonfiction, basically about how you should think or like program your brain to think so that your opinions reflect the truth. I'm making it sound very, but this book is so well written. I can't wait to reread this. Oh, you know how much I loved Cradle from Will Wright? That man has written another series and it was, or maybe it still is, free on Audible. So I was like, let me see that. It's like a trilogy, but each of the 3 books has a companion novel of sorts. So it's basically 6 books, but only 1 story. It's a bit confusing. I tried to read the first one of Sea and Shadow. This one's from the male protagonist's point of view, and of Shadow and Sea is from the female point of view. I read both of them. The male one was passable. The female one, it is only because I like Cradle so much that I went on and then read Of Darkness and Dawn as well, which is the 2nd book, female perspective. Then I rated it 2 stars and didn't continue reading. So I was so down on having read a few lower quality books in a row that I went back to my all-time favorite, Brent Weeks, the Lightbringer series. The 1st book is The Black Prism, then we have The Blinding Knife, The Broken Eye, The Blood Mirror and The Burning White. I absolutely adore this series, even though I do have to put an asterisk on it, because I absolutely adore everything about the books, except for the ending. I think I can't spoil anything. Well, I don't like the ending, all I'm gonna say. We Are the Water People by Troy Onyango. Audible original, I think it's free to listen to, so that's why I listen to it. I'm gonna say fantasy. It's about people living near a large body of water. And I think the premise is good and all that, but the execution is just... Glitch, a short story by Hugh Howie. It's about an artificial intelligence in a robot. Robot. And as I said this to you, you should know everything that's gonna happen in this short story. If you ever read any sci-fi about AIs, you will know. Euphoria by Lily King. Hated this book. Hated it. Do not read that. Don't need to know anything else. The Neil Gaiman at the End of the Universe. An Audible original short story by Irvind Ethan David. And the point is that Neil Gaiman reads this. He is the audiobook narrator. Nothing mind-blowing, but if you have Audible, it's free to listen to and it's very short, like half an hour. Do recommend doing that. Your Head is a Houseboat, A Chaotic Guide to Mental Clarity by Campbell Walker. One of the few books that I actually have a physical copy of. And this book is a must read for basically anybody. It's a picture book about mental clarity for adults. And it's amazing. Oracle by Andrew Piper. Mystery, thriller, murder, supernatural. Nice one. Viva Durant and the Madness of Madame Bouchard. The sequel to Viva Durant and The Secret of Silver Buttons, I think. By Ashley Armand. Middle grade detective stories. My daughter absolutely adores both of them. And I like the second one way better than the first one. Even though I think even the first one is very well done. It has like some background noises and such. High recommend for me. Find Us by Benjamin Stevenson. Contemporary mystery thriller. Very many twists and turns. Again, don't think about it too much after you read it. But yeah, it's fine. A Change of Plans by Dennis E. Taylor. A short science fiction story, which is fine. I think it's free on Audible, so. Proxima Rising by Brandon Q. Morris. I did not like this book. I absolutely loved the beginning. It started off as a great hard science fiction. I was like, ooh, what are they gonna do next? And then it just fell flat. And I mean so flat. The Coldest Case, a Black Book audio drama by James Patterson. I like this one. Has nothing to do with a cold case. It's not a cold case. They are working on a very hot case, like very, very hot, constantly developing. This Is How You Lose the Time War by Amal El-Mohtar, sorry, and Max Gladstone. I've heard so many good things about this book and I hated it. It's supposed to be a science fiction, you know, time war. I don't see how you can have time war in your title and not expect me to expect that this is a science fiction novel. And it isn't. A Victorian era romance in a fiction-y, futuristic setting. Did not care for it. Lux by Brandon Sanderson and Stephen Bowles. Science fiction. I think it's supposed to be like a sister novel of the Reckoner series. But you can tell that Brandon didn't really work on this one. It has child abuse that's passed off as, well, this is how stuff goes. Buried Leads by Lindy Walker. Oh, this is the sequel to The Journalist. This time I remembered. So this is the journalist who's solving cases. Love her detective work. Love the character portrayals in here. Love the descriptions. Love the voice. What I hate about this particular book here is that in the end, all of her detective work doesn't actually uncover the villain, but the villain comes by and does a monologue scene. Saturn's Monsters by Thomas K. Carpenter. Another one of those where a male writer is trying to write a female in science fiction. This is a stupid book and nobody should read it. Awakening by Brandon Sanderson. Infinity Blade series, I think this is from. The first book, it's fine. Recursion by Black Crouch. Science fiction, time travel. It has some very, very nice ideas. It's fairly well written. But you have these characters who are so incredibly smart. And they do some stupid things. Stupid. But fun ideas. So, am I recommending this? Not sure. Piranesi by Susanna Clarke. I'm gonna say this is fantasy, but I cannot say anything more without giving you major spoilers. Above all, it's a mystery novel. And keep that in mind while you are reading it, because the first few chapters are hard to get through. Christie's Great Idea by Anne M. Martin. This is the first book in the Babysitter's Club, which are books that are fairly well known, even though this was my first time hearing about them. And I listened to it with my kids and I loved it. They loved it. I can see why so many people like it. Absolutely. And then the second book in the series was Claudia and the Phantom Phone Calls. We loved that one as well. So there you go. Then I tried to read the second book from the trilogy that has a companion novel from Will White. Remember that one from a few minutes ago? This one is Of Dawn and Darkness. And people, I mean, if this is what Will had to write so that Cradle could come out of him, I'm glad he did those books. But I'm really not sure if I'm gonna read the third books in the series. And the last entry, The Blade Itself by Joe Abercrombie. Heard so much about this book. It's apparently one of the fantasy classics by now. I felt it was fine, but it left me much desiring many, many a thing. Like likable characters, female characters on the whole. So yeah, maybe you found some things to put on your to-be-read list. Because we all need more stuff on there. Yeah. Well, until the next time you click on one of my videos. Bye-bye. Robot? Robot? It's not a rowboat. Robot.